Can you imagine what your life would be like if your day ended at sunset? This means you will have approximately 12 hours to do whatever you had to do. The alternative would be to rely on candles and lanterns to do your homework, cook dinner, or have a bath. You wouldn't be able to get anything done, not easily anyway. If you were a tailor, you would risk cutting up the wrong fabric or stitching the wrong way. If you were a carpenter, how would you be able to put the right pieces together? Children would damage their eyes trying to get their homework done or risk failing. It sounds very tedious, doesn't it? A bit exaggerated and hard. And yet, this is the reality of more than 50% of the country's population. According to USAID, Nigeria is the largest economy in the sub-Saharan Africa. But limitations in the power sector constrains its growth. Nigeria is endowed with large oil, gas, hydro, and solar resources, which has a potential of generating 12,522 megawatts of electricity. On some days, our country is only capable of producing 4,000 megawatts of electricity, which is insufficient to a country whose population is over 195 million people. For some of us, we can simply turn on the generator when the power goes out. Many homes in the country don't even have electricity to begin with. Some areas see as little as an hour of electricity, which simply isn't enough. When our teacher provided us a list of projects to choose from for our annual science fair, my partner and I realized this was a good opportunity to explore a power alternative that was low cost, portable, and easy to build. A mini hydroelectric power generator. Yes, it does sound big and fancy, and usually it is. Typically, a hydraulic turbine converts the kinetic energy of flowing water into mechanical energy, and the hydroelectric power generator converts this mechanical energy into electricity. The operation of a generator is based on the principles discovered by Michael Faraday. He found that when a magnet moves past a conductor, it causes electricity to flow. But we didn't build a large generator. We built a small one using old pieces of wood, plastic strewn from takeaway packs, an abandoned rotor, and some connecting wires. Remember, we are trying to provide a solution for those people who are literally doing enough to survive every day. So how would this help? The portable generator generates 0.5 volts of electricity. You can power a light bulb. Did you know that something as little as having power can significantly boost a person's productivity? Research has shown that lightning plays a large role in people's mood too. So once again, imagine a household getting dark at sunset. But this time we have a solution. One or two or even three hydroelectric power generators are powered up and everyone can go about their normal routine as usual. Step into the light with me. For every problem, there is a solution. You can think big and struggle to get that great goal, or start small and work your way up. Thank you.